My research group is interested in the mechanics and physics of nanoscale materials and interfaces. In particular, we are interested in finding out the mechanical force, heat, electrical current carrying capability of nanoscale materials. We are also interested in finding out how these materials fail when you put too much mechanical force or heat and so on. So we are hardcore experimentalists. We use nanofabrication a lot to miniaturize experiments so that they could work on specimens that are very, very small.
As a mechanical engineer, it's very important for us to design and simulate the device before you actually fabricate and test it. For example, my research is all about interfaces between materials at nanoscale. So very big challenge is in integration of these interfaces with the microscale testing device. So what we do is like we use commercially available softwares like the CAD-based or the finite element-based softwares to simulate it and test under various experimental conditions. And then we optimize the setup and then we do the actual fabrication and test it experimentally.
So to characterize the material property in mechanical, thermal or electrical field, we need to make very small devices. We call them MEMS or micro devices. These devices are very tiny. For example, in transmission electron microscope, the allowable device size is only 3 millimeter by 5 millimeter. So to make these devices, we have to go through nano fabrication process of the MSC building of Penn State. And we usually start with a silicon wafer, and then we deposit different kind of material. It could be a metallic material or a semiconducting or an oxide, or it could be a noble material. Then we need to decide which part of the material we want to take or remove and which part of the material we want to keep. And for that, we usually use the photolithography. After the lithography, then we remove material by using wet etching, where you use a combination of acids or solvents or other liquids to remove the material. Or the removing material or etching process can be done in the dry etching process, where a combination of gases are used. And Penn State have all the equipments to do all this kind of stuff. And after etching the material, we usually have our micro devices, which we use for the material characterization.
We also heavily use microscopes because we need to see these specimens.
We can measure the properties in the microscope, like in the scanning electron microscope, we can measure the mechanical properties. We can apply stress on the sample and to test how much force these thin films can stand. So in the transmission electron microscope, we can visualize how the microstructure changes with the externally applied stimuli. For example, we can see how the microstructure changes with very high temperature. We also use infrared thermal microscope to characterize the thermal properties of thin films. For example, we can easily get the thermal mapping of these thin films, and we can measure the temperature profile along the thin films to measure the thermal conductivity.
Infrastructure is the key to my research. Penn State has excellent nanofabrication and materials characterization facilities, so it's very simple. If you have a research idea that is a game-changing one, Penn State will have the means to execute it.
I'm an undergrad here at Penn State. Currently, I'm preparing samples for the transmission electron microscope. These samples will be tested by a dielectric breakdown test that will be performed on the transmission electron microscope itself. My research has shown me a whole other side of engineering, dealing with things on micro or even nano scale. This has truly enriched my engineering experience here.
I am currently making an energy harvesting device which will transfer the waste heat into useful electricity. This research is really meaningful for me because it allows me to have experience of real hands-on laboratory works, and at the same time, I can practice what I learned from the class.
Well, our research is mostly basic science, so it does not add to the benefit of the society immediately. But think about it this way, how the electronics industry has shaped our society. And then think of our contributions and how it develops to the knowledge that the engineers are going to design the future electronic or future energy conversion type applications. Having said that, we also do some product development kind of research. For example, currently we are designing and we are making a device that will convert waste heat to electricity, and it will increase the power output or the efficiency by more than 10 times. Since energy economy directly impacts the society in many ways, we are very happy to contribute it.